Hello and good morning, dear students. I am Professor Vandana Pai. In today's lecture of the subject Relationship Management, which is prescribed to the class B Book 3rd, Financial Markets and Services, Semester 5, we will be studying steps to maintain and sustain business relationship. See, business relationship, till now we have gone through many of the concepts into business relationship. Okay, see, every time we are revising business relationship. Why? Because, okay, see, if you are clear with the meaning of business relationship, then it would be much better for you to connect with any content of Unit number 1, Business Relationship Management. So, prior to actually going through the steps to maintain and sustain business relationship, what we will be doing is, yes, definitely we will revise the meaning of business relationship management. Okay, then we will move towards steps to maintain and sustain business relationship. Business relationship management means what? Yes, relationship management at business level. Okay, let's see what it means. BRM. Yes, this is the abbreviation for the extended form business relationship management. Okay, what is it? Let's see. BRM is a set of skills that provide a way to collaborate in a way that maximizes the value of each business area. Yes. What is BRM? BRM is a set of skills that provide a way to collaborate in a way that maximizes the value of each business area. बघा, याचा अर्थ काय आहे? BRM म्हणजे काय? BRM सेट आहे. ओके, कलेक्शन आहे. BRM म्हणजे बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप मॅनेजमेंट काय आहे? तर एक सेट आहे. ओके, कशाचं सेट आहे? सेट ऑफ स्किल्स. ओके, सेट ऑफ स्किल्स. ओके, वेगवेगळ्या स्किल्सचा एक सेट आहे, एक कलेक्शन आहे. ओके, हे सेट ऑफ स्किल्स काय करतं बघा. येस, द सेट ऑफ स्किल्स प्रोव्हाइड्स अ वे टू कोलॅबरेट. ओके, सी, दिस सेट ऑफ स्किल्स विच इज इन्क्लुडेड इन BRM, दॅट इज बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप मॅनेजमेंट, इट प्रोव्हाइड्स अ वे, इट प्रोव्हाइड्स अ वे टू कोलॅबरेट. Okay, collaborate means what? Yes, collaborate itself means that, yes, to connect. Okay, this set of skill, what it does? Yes, it provides a way to connect in a way that maximizes, yes, in a way that maximizes the value of each business area. Okay, see, due to this what happens? Okay, the value of each business area, whatsoever business area might be, okay, the value means the outcome, it is always maximized. Okay, see, in business relationship management what is done actually? Okay, all the skills which are related, they are collected together. Okay, and the skills, they help to maximize the value of each business area. Okay, getting it? See, BRM, that is business relationship management, it aims to maintain a positive relationship with customers. Okay, See what it says? Business relationship management. Yes. See, business relationship management, it aims to maintain, yes, a positive relation means good relation, sound relation, okay, sound means good relation, okay, or positive relationship with whom? With the customers. See, customer, okay, customer is treated as the king of market, okay, you are aware about this, right? Customer is treated as the king of market or is termed as a king of market. Okay. Why so? Because see, every business activities nowadays, okay, they are supposed to be C2C. What it means? See, every business activity, they are supposed to be C2C. C2C means what? Yes. They should start at customer needs and they should end at customer satisfaction. Okay, what it means? Say, if you manufacture a product which will be exactly matching with the customer needs, okay, which will be exactly matching with the customer needs, then what will happen? Yes, due to this, surely, okay, the customer will prefer the good whichever you are presenting in the market. Okay, means it will start with customer needs, it will end at customer satisfaction. Okay, see, and the satisfied customer, what they will do? They will refer your product to other people, to their friends, to their relatives, to their people whom they know. Okay, due to this, what will happen? Yes, there will be positive relationship with the customers. Okay, and due to positive relationship with the customer, what will happen? Yes, see, for the growth of business, you need to sustain the customers, isn't it? You need to, yes, have retain the customer base. Okay, now if, for example, okay, think that, or imagine, for example, if you visited a grocery shop and, okay, the person, the owner of grocery shop, the shopkeeper actually, okay, if the owner of that shop or the shopkeeper, if he not even attended you, okay, or you went there to purchase a 10 rupees pen, is it? Considering your order or considering whatsoever your demand, okay, as it was of rupees 10 only, okay, what he did is, yes, he accepted the demands of other people and he fulfilled their demand, and you are waiting for half an hour or more than that for a single pen. How you would feel? Or if the shopkeeper speaks with you in arrogant manner, how you will feel? Yes, surely you will feel bad, right? Okay. And another shopkeeper whom you visited, okay, he spoke with you in a good manner, in a polite manner, okay, though you visited his shop for a 10 rupees pen, still he spoke with you sweet voice or with a good words, okay, how you will feel? Yes, you will feel good. And another time, which shop you will visit? Shop number one, who spoke with you in arrogant manner, or shop number two, who spoke with you in a positive manner, in a good manner? Surely you will visit the second shop, right? Okay, why? Because that person, he had honestly, politely, okay, softly he spoke with you, and yes, he fulfilled the demand in time, and even he didn't made you stand for a long period of time or wait for a long period of time, isn't it? Okay, so this is what the positive relationship is. Okay, see, business relationship management aims to maintain a positive relationship with customers. It identifies the needs of existing and potential customers. Okay, see, in business relationship management, what is done? Okay, needs are highlighted. Needs of existing, okay, presently who are consuming your product, okay, those customers, as well as potential customers. See, potential, what it means, see, I will explain to you the word potential. Potential means today they are not your customers, but in future, okay, they are likely to become your customer. Sambhavya grahak, jala marathi madhe mhantat, okay. See, these people, their needs, okay, is identified by business relationship management. Then, and ensures that appropriate services are developed to meet those needs. Okay, appropriate services are developed to meet those needs. Okay, means in business relationship management, what is done? See, yes, it aims to maintain a positive relations with the customer. Okay, then through this, the needs of existing and potential customers is identified. Okay, then yes, appropriate services, okay, maybe the after sales services or the services whichever are required, okay, those services are developed in such a way that, in such a way that the needs are met, the needs are met, okay. बघा, बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप मॅनेजमेंटचं एम काय आहे? तर पॉझिटिव्ह रिलेशनशिप कस्टमर बरोबर मेंटेन करणे. ओके, त्याच्यानंतर बघा, इथे एक्झिस्टिंग आणि जे पोटेन्शियल कस्टमर्स आहेत त्यांचे नीड्स हायलाईट केले जातात. बघा, एक्झिस्टिंग कस्टमर म्हणजे ऑलरेडी जे कस्टमर तुमचा माल किंवा तुमचे गुड्स, तुमचं प्रोडक्ट विकत घेतात, अशा कस्टमर्सला आपण काय म्हणतो? एक्झिस्टिंग कस्टमर्स असं म्हणतो. ओके, आणि पोटेन्शियल कस्टमर्स, पोटेन्शियल कस्टमर म्हणजे कोण? पोटेन्शियल कस्टमर म्हणजे असे कस्टमर्स आहेत जे जनरल पब्लिकमध्ये आहेत. ओके, त्यांना तुमच्या प्रोडक्टविषयी माहिती असेल नसेल, ओके, ते आत्ता तुमचे कस्टमर्स नाहीत, पण भविष्यकाळात ते तुमचे कस्टमर्स होऊ शकतात. अशा कस्टमर्सला काय म्हटलं जातं? पोटेन्शियल कस्टमर्स असं म्हटलं जातं. ओके, त्यालाच आपण मराठीमध्ये संभाव्य ग्राहक असं म्हणतो. ओके, अँड एन्श्युअर्स दॅट अप्रोप्रिएट सर्व्हिसेस आर डेव्हलप्ड टू मीट दोज नीड्स. अप्रोप्रिएट सर्व्हिसेस आर डेव्हलप्ड टू मीट दोज नीड्स. ओके, बघा, अजून काय केलं जातं BRM मध्ये, बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप मॅनेजमेंट डे? ओके, कन्फर्म केलं जातं की जे कस्टमरला रिक्वायर्ड आहेत ते सर्व सर्व्हिसेस, सो द अप्रोप्रिएट सर्व्हिसेस, ओके, ॲज पर द नीड्स ऑफ कस्टमर्स. ओके, फॉर एक्झाम्पल, सी, होम डिलिव्हरी सर्व्हिस, आफ्टर सेल सर्व्हिस, रिपेरिंग सर्व्हिसेस, ओके, such kind of services. If your customer, they are in need of all these types of services, if they are in need of all these types of services, identify it and generate such type of services in order to meet with the requirements and needs of the customers. Okay, बघा काय केलं जातं. तर जे एक्झिस्टिंग आणि पोटेन्शियल कस्टमर्स आहेत, जे एक्झिस्टिंग आणि पोटेन्शियल कस्टमर्स आहेत, तर ते एक्झिस्टिंग आणि पोटेन्शियल कस्टमर्सला जे सर्व्हिसेस नीडेड आहेत, जे सर्व्हिसेस नीडेड आहेत म्हणजे फॉर एक्झाम्पल कसले, तर बघा होम डिलिव्हरी सर्व्हिसेस किंवा आफ्टर सेल सर्व्हिसेस, ओके, समजा अशा प्रकारचे सर्व्हिसेस किंवा अजून बऱ्याच प्रकारे सर्व्हिसेस असतात, ओके, ते समजा त्यांना रिक्वायर्ड असतील, ओके, तर बी प्रॉम्प्ट टू मीट दोज नीड्स, ओके. असं कोण म्हणतं? बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप मॅनेजमेंट, ओके. सो गेटिंग इट, वॉट इज बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप मॅनेजमेंट? ओके, डेव्हलपिंग अ रिलेशन विथ द कस्टमर, ओके, बाय आयडेंटिफाईंग देअर नीड्स, ओके, अँड प्रोव्हाइडिंग अप्रोप्रिएट सर्व्हिसेस सो एज यू कॅन सॅटिस्फाय देम. ओके, गेटिंग इट? Objectives of business relationship management. Let's see what are the different objectives of business relationship management. See, after revising the meaning of business relationship management, okay, let's move towards the main content of today's lecture, that is steps to maintain and sustain business relationship. See, first of all, we should be thinking about why to maintain business relationship, then we will move towards the steps. Okay, see, why to maintain business relationship? Okay, yes because in our objectives of business relationship, okay, we had studied that. See, the stakeholders, are they important? Yes, they are important. Why they are important? Okay, why we should care about the relationship generated through our business? Why? Because, okay, when we consider our business, see, the business is a part of society, isn't it? The business is a part of society. What it means? Yes, the business is incorporated in the society, the business nurtures in the society, the business grows up in the society. Yes, the business is for the society, okay, and it can live only with the support of society, isn't it? So, why to maintain business relationship? Yes, because if we are not capable to maintain the relationship with the stakeholders, surely they will withdraw their part of interest from your business and you will be nowhere. Okay, means, see, for example, okay, one of the stakeholder, that is customer, see, while discussing the concept of stakeholder, while discussing the concept of stakeholder, we have gone through this. See, what is the interest of customer into your organization, isn't it? We have discussed this. Yes, what is the role of this person, this customer, into your business? See, in this 21st century, in this modern era, customer is said to be, or customer is called as king of the market, isn't it? Customer is called as king of the market. Means what? What do you mean by king of market? Yes, when it comes to king of market, means what? See, if nowadays, okay, if you are not able to recreate your business C2C, okay,
then you will fail to have a position in the market. Means what? What is this C2C? See, in one of the last lecture, we have discussed this C2C concept. Yes, see, nowadays, everything, whatsoever, okay, the product which you will be selecting, okay, the location, the place of your business, okay, everything, whatsoever you are doing, yes, or whenever you are thinking about your product, means you are thinking about the product idea, what you should be doing? When we think about product idea, always first and foremost thing is what your customer needs. Okay, what your customer needs, yes, you should always be focusing on it. What your customer needs, okay, always you should be focusing on this. Means what? Yes. First, what you can do is, you can have a survey in the market. Through that you can gather or collect the needs of the customer. As per the needs of customer, try to add those needs into the features of your product, okay, and develop a product which will be satisfying all the needs of the customer, okay, as per the list which you have collected. See, then, okay, after considering the needs of customer, whenever you develop a product, okay, and present that product in the market, what will happen? Yes, the product which you have generated, okay, actually it does contains all the features which your customer needs. Due to this, what will happen? The product features and the customer needs, they are matching to each other. They are one and the same. Okay, your product can satisfy the customer. Okay, now whenever your customer is satisfied, what will happen then? Surely he will repurchase your product. This is all about customer. Is it? So if you ignore the customer will ignore your product. Okay? If you ignore customer, the customer will ignore your product. Okay? Likewise, your customers will be diverted from your organization, and one day, yes, you will be required to close your business. Okay? Was this the motive of incorporating the business? Yes, in the near future to close the business. Was this the motive when you have incorporated your business? No, this was not the motive. Isn't it? Okay, बघा, जेव्हा आपण कस्टमरचा विचार करतो, कस्टमर कोण आहे? Yes, कस्टमर इम्पॉर्टंट आहे का? कस्टमर खूप इम्पॉर्टंट आहे, कारण की त्याला किंग ऑफ द मार्केट म्हटलेलं आहे. ग्राहक हा बाजारपेठेचा राजा आहे असं म्हटलं जातं. ओके, बघा, बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप मेंटेन करणं का गरजेचं आहे हे बघतोय आपण आत्ता. ओके, तर हा जो कस्टमर आहे त्याचे काही नीड्स असतात, गरजा असतात, बरोबर आहे? त्या कस्टमरच्या काही गरजा असतात. ओके, तर ह्या गरजा तो प्रोडक्ट विकत घेऊन भागवणार असतो, किंवा इज इट भागवण्याचा प्रयत्न करत असतो. आता जेव्हा आपण कस्टमरचा विचार करतो, ओके, हा जो कस्टमर आहे ज्याला आपण बाजारपेठेचा राजा म्हणतोय, बघा, खरंच आहे का तो राजा? आहे. का आहे? कारण की आजकाल जे सर्व बिझनेसेस आहेत, ते बिझनेसेस एक कन्सेप्ट त्यांनी अडॉप्ट केलेली आहे. कोणती कन्सेप्ट आहे ती? येस, सी टू सी कन्सेप्ट. म्हणजे काय बघा तुमची प्रोडक्ट आयडिया ओके तुमच्या बिझनेसची जे प्रोडक्ट आयडिया आहे किंवा तुमचा बिझनेस थ्रू कोणतं प्रोडक्ट प्रोड्यूस करायचं हे जेव्हा तुम्ही थिंक करता तेव्हा फर्स्ट अँड फॉरमोस्ट थिंग जे तुम्हाला कन्सिडर करावं लागेल ते म्हणजे काय की ग्राहकाला काय हवं आहे ओके ग्राहकाला काय हवं आहे हे जेव्हा तुम्ही फाइंड आउट करता ओके आणि त्यानुसार जेव्हा तुम्ही प्रोडक्ट डेव्हलप करता ओके आणि इज इट त्यानुसार जेव्हा तुम्ही प्रोडक्ट तयार करता आणि मार्केटमध्ये इंट्रोड्यूस करता ओके ग्राहकांच्या गरजा भागवणारं प्रोडक्ट असतं ते त्यामुळे ग्राहक ते विकत घेतात ते विकत घेऊन त्याचा उपभोग घेतात आणि येस त्यांना एक प्रकारचं समाधान त्याच्या थ्रू मिळतं आणि ग्राहक जेव्हा समाधानी होतो ओके पुन्हा तो तुमचं प्रोडक्ट परचेस करतो आणि ओके ज्याला माउथ पब्लिसिटी म्हणतो ओके त्या प्रकारे तो त्याच्या फॅमिली फ्रेंड्स ओळखीचे सगळ्यांना तुमच्या प्रोडक्टचं रेफरन्स देतो आता हे कधी शक्य आहे जेव्हा तुम्ही ग्राहकाला इम्पॉर्टन्स देता ग्राहकाकडे लक्ष देता तुम्ही समजा त्यांना इग्नोर केलं तर काय होईल हेच ग्राहक जे आहेत ते तुमच्या प्रोडक्टला इग्नोर करतील ओके आणि आपल्या प्रोडक्टला समजा त्यांनी इग्नोर केलं तर काय होऊ शकेल बघा त्याला तुमच्या कॉम्पिटिटर्स प्रोडक्ट प्रोव्हाइड करतील पण ओके तुम्ही समजा एखादा ग्राहक लूज केला तर तो पुन्हा परत तुमचं प्रोडक्ट विकत घ्यायला येणार नाही अशा प्रकारे तुम्ही जेव्हा कस्टमर्स लूज करत जाता ओके एक दिवस ओके तुम्हाला तुमचा बिझनेस बंद करावा लागतो ओके त्यामुळे हे जे स्टेक होल्डर्स आहेत त्यांच्याबरोबर रिलेशनशिप बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप मेंटेन करणं खूप गरजेचं आहे ओके सो हाऊ टू मेंटेन अँड सस्टेन बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप ओके दिस वॉज वन ऑफ द की फॅक्टर अमाँग द स्टेक होल्डर ओके लाईकवाईज एव्हरी फॅक्टर्स आर दे आर इम्पॉर्टंट ॲक्च्युली ओके बट वी विल नॉट डिस्कस एव्हरी फॅक्टर ओके हिअर वी विल नाव मूव टुवर्ड्स द स्टेप्स टू मेंटेन अँड सस्टेन बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप ओके द फर्स्ट वन इज कीप अ लुक आउट फॉर की इन्फ्लुएन्सर्स सी देर आर सम की फॅक्टर्स देर आर सम सर्टन की फॅक्टर्स ओके विच कॅन इन्फ्लुएन्स द बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप ओके द बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप्स कॅन बी इन्फ्लुएन्स्ड ओके द बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप्स कॅन बी इन्फ्लुएन्स्ड बाय सम ऑफ द की फॅक्टर्स ओके दोज की फॅक्टर्स कॅन हॅव अँड इन्फ्लुएन्स on your relationship with your stakeholders, with your customers and all. Okay? Always, you should keep a keen eye on all those things. Bagha, businesses madhe, bareshe factors astat. Okay? Te factors, influencers cha kaam kartat. Influencers manje, okay? Tya factors mule. ओके तुमचं आणि तुमच्या स्टेकहोल्डर्समधलं जे रिलेशनशिप आहे ते हार्म होऊ शकतं फॉर एक्झाम्पल चेंज ग्रोथ ओके ग्रोथ ऑफ युअर बिझनेस प्रॉफिट ओके एक्सपान्शन चेंजेस इन द मार्केट ओके हे सर्व फॅक्टर्स आहेत ह्या सर्व फॅक्टर्समुळे काय होऊ शकतं येस ह्या सर्व फॅक्टर्समुळे तुमचे जे रिलेशनशिप्स आहेत बिझनेस रिलेशनशिप्स आहेत ते काय होऊ शकतात अफेक्ट होऊ शकतात ओके सो ऑलवेज ॲज अ बिझनेसमन व्हॉट यू शुड बी डूईंग येस यू शुड ऑलवेज बी फोकसिंग ऑन ऑल दिस की इन्फ्लुएन्सर okay, which can affect or which can strengthen your relationship with your stakeholder. Okay, getting it? Then focus on exceptional communication. Focus on exceptional communication. What it means? See, how your communication should be with your stakeholders. Yes, good, polite, positive, isn't it? Okay, whenever you are speaking or conversating with one of your stakeholder, yes, there should be always a reflection of honesty, politeness, and your words. Everything should go in a positive direction, in a vertical direction. Okay? Means what? Yes. Always. You should mark your words. Okay? The promises which you have done to all these stakeholders. Okay? Are you able to fulfill all these things? Okay? Focus on it. If you are not able to fulfill, then what you need to do? Yes, if you are not able to fulfill all your promises, surely, due to this, your relationship with the stakeholder might be affected. Okay, so focus on exceptional communication means what? Here, always you should care about the words which you are using. Okay, focus on politeness, focus on, okay, sound relationship, harmonious, okay, have a harmony into your communication and the relationship with your customers and other stakeholders. Okay, then find common interest means what? See, find common interest means why the stakeholders are with you. Yes, in the very first lecture itself, okay, I had explained this to you. Yes, why the stakeholders are with you? Because they do have interest into your organization. Isn't it? They do have interest into your organization. Okay? Now, who are included in stakeholders? Yes, all those people who do have interest into your organization, they are included in the concept of stakeholder. Okay? Getting it? So, when we consider the stakeholders, for example, shareholders. Okay, shareholders, what is their interest into your organization? Yes, they have contributed, na? They have contributed something towards your business. Yes, they have contributed capital, isn't it? And they are looking into your business for their reward, which is associated with the profit. Is it? If you are on the wrong track, you will not earn profit. Then their interest will be affected. Their reward, their return will be affected. Isn't it? Then, customers. Yes. What is their interest into your organization? Yes. Now, at this moment, if your product is available to them, Okay, they will be curious that whenever and the next time they will feel need of your product, will it be available to them? Then the employees, what is their interest? Their interest is that, yes, surely, they are working with you. Both workers as well as office bearers, they are working with you for work. Okay, after working for long period of time, they expect something from you. What is it? Yes, the reward for what they have, for the work which they have done, isn't it? So when you will be able to give or pay their part of reward? Yes. Only when, yes, you will be earning suitable amount of profit. Isn't it? Means your business is going on the right track. Okay, then only it will be possible. Likewise, all the stakeholders, okay, they do have this interest. So what you need to do is, you need to find out their interests, okay? Then maintain a positive attitude, okay? See, when we consider business, someday, yes, you will be earning profit. Someday, you will be facing losses or suffering losses. Isn't it? See, when you constantly go on suffering losses, yes, you find that everything is impossible now. Isn't it? Okay, but with the help of your stakeholders itself, okay, you can rebuild your energy and be at the first position. Okay, this can happen. So in any phase of your business, okay, you should be having a positive attitude always. Then join online and offline conversations. Okay, join online and offline conversations with whom? Yes, online and offline conversations with whom? Surely with your stakeholders, that too with your customers. Okay, means whenever we think about the business processes C2C, okay, yes, every time, once in a while, if you have collected the information about what your customer needs, and years on you are using the same information and producing the product. Is that enough? No, that is not enough. Bagha, kadhi kone ke kali tumhi customer needs a survey ghetla, tacha through data collect kela ane tacha varti, okay, then needs varti work karun tumhi tumcha product develop kela. Okay, ani shanta baslat. Okay, jhale 10 12 varsha tumhi tes product chalu thevta. चालेल का? नाही. ओके, बघा, टाइमली आफ्टर अ इंटरवल तुम्ही त्या कस्टमरशी, ओके, एक फीडबॅक घेणं, फॉलोअप घेणं, त्यांना अजून काय गरजेचं आहे, ओके, त्यांची नीड्स काय आहेत ते बघणं गरजेचं आहे. का? बिकॉज यू नीड टू मॉडिफाय युअर प्रोडक्ट, राईट? यू नीड टू मॉडिफाय युअर प्रोडक्ट. ओके, फॉर एक्झाम्पल टू व्हीलर्स, इज इट? टू व्हीलर्स, ओके, बघा, 30 वर्षापूर्वी जे मोटरसायकल्स मिळायचे आणि आत्ता जे मोटरसायकल मिळतात त्यात फरक आहे का? भरपूर फरक आहे. ओके, भरपूर त्याच्यामध्ये, म्हणजे फॉर एक्झाम्पल नॉन गिअरचे समजा आपण व्हेकल्स बघितले, नॉन गेअरचे व्हेकल्स बघितले. ओके, आधी त्याच्यामध्ये एक दोनच प्रोडक्ट होते. ओके, आणि ते सुद्धा ओके फक्त आणि फक्त विमेन्सला कन्सिडर करून ते प्रोडक्ट, मोपेड ज्याला म्हणतो आपण, ते डेव्हलप झालेलं. ओके, आता जे मोपेड किंवा टू व्हीलर, नॉन गेअर टू व्हीलर आपण विचार करतो, ओके, तर त्याच्यामध्ये वेट कॅरी करण्यासाठी ओके किंवा स्टोरेज चं ऑप्शन दिलेलं आहेत, असे बरेचसे ऑप्शन्स दिलेत. ओके, बघा हे कशामुळे झालं, तर कोणीतरी सांगितलं, कोणीतरी बघितलं, कोणीतरी सर्वे केला, याच्या थ्रूच हे सगळे मॉडिफिकेशन घडलेत. बरोबर आहे. ओके, आता जे मोपेड बघतो आपण, ते बोथ इज इट फिमेलसुद्धा आणि मेल्ससुद्धा वापरतात, इज इट, बिकॉज दोघांसाठीही ते कम्फर्टेबल गाडी आहे, इज इंट इट. तशाच प्रकारे ओके वॉट यू डू इज, ॲज अ बिझनेसमॅन यू हॅव अ कॉन्व्हर्सेशन विथ युअर कस्टमर्स. येस, शुअरली दे विल कन्वे देअर ॲडिशनल नीड्स टू यू ॲज पर दॅट. ओके, विच वेअर इज फिजिबल फॉर यू, मॉडिफाय इट इन टू युअर प्रोडक्ट अँड प्रेझेंट दॅट प्रोडक्ट. ओके, देन ट्रीट क्लायंट ॲज अन इंडिव्हिज्युअल. येस, द क्लायंट इज अ पर्सन, ही इज अन इंडिव्हिज्युअल, राईट. ओके, ही हॅज सर्टन इमोशन्स. ओके, यू शुड बी हॅविंग अ फीचर इन टू यू, एम्पथी. ओके, एम्पथी, वॉट इज एम्पथी? बघा, एम्पथी म्हणजे काय? एम्पथी, सिम्पथी, राईट, बरेचसे असे वर्ड्स आपण ऐकलेत. इज इट सिम्पथी मीन्स, सी, इफ समवन इज सॉरो, इफ समवन इज इमोशनल, ओके, वेन यू फील हिज इमोशन्स, इज इट, यू फील हिज इमोशन अँड यू कॉन्वर्सेट विथ दॅट पर्सन. ओके, वॉट यू डू इज, येस, यू ट्राय टू से सम ओके थिंग्स. ओके, यू ट्राय टू कॉन्वर्सेट विथ दॅट पर्सन सो दॅट ओके ही विल बी आउट फ्रॉम द इमोशनल फेज अँड ऑल, इज इट, इट दॅट इज एम्पथी. वॉट इज एम्पथी? ओके, सी, यू शुड बी एबल टू नो द इमोशन्स ऑफ अदर पर्सन, इज इट, इन द सेम सेन्स. येस, ट्रीट क्लायंट ॲज अन इंडिव्हिज्युअल मीन्स, ओके, सी, यू शुड बी एबल, यू शुड बी एबल टू नो द इमोशन्स ऑफ युअर कस्टमर्स अँड ऑलवेज केअर अबाउट द इमोशन्स ऑफ द कस्टमर्स. देन प्रोव्हाइड व्हॅल्युएबल इन्फॉर्मेशन. ओके, सी, you know the helplines and all, right? Okay, why those helplines are made? Whenever a person sticks up or stucks up into some problems related to the product or all or anything like that, what they do, they call you. So here you need to provide them the valuable information which you need to provide it to them. Share your opinions. Share your opinions means what? Yes, for example, okay, if you want to modify something into your product, the modification should be conveyed to your stakeholders. Means, yes, you should always be participating your stakeholders into the decision making activity, because okay, some of the suggestions or recommendations suggested by your stakeholders might mark a distinctiveness into your product. Okay, through that, whatsoever product which you introduce in the market, yes, it can be innovative and it can be competitive also. Then meet and support your contacts. Yes, you should contact, meet and take the support from all your stakeholders. Why? Because it is quite needed. Okay, because when it comes to business. Every day is not the same when we consider the business. Some day you will be earning profit, some day you will be suffering from losses, okay? Some day the situation might be vice versa. Okay, at the situation, if you think that you should get out of the situation, particularly when you are constantly suffering from losses, what you should do? Yes, you should meet your contacts, okay, and ask for their support. So these are all the steps which you can take to sustain and maintain the business relationship. With this, we conclude today's lecture. Thank you.